ഹലോ മിസ്റ്റർ ടീച്ചർ. ഹലോ, വാ യു?
ഹൈ ഫ്രണ്ട്സ്, ഐ എം ഹിയർ ആൻഡ് വെൽക്കം യു ഓൾ ടു ദ ഫസ്റ്റ് ബെൽ.
ഷാൾ വി കണ്ടിന്യൂ ദ സ്റ്റോറി ഓഫ് ഫാദർ ഗില്ലിഗൻ? ഫാദർ പീറ്റർ ഗില്ലിഗൻ ഈസ് സ്ലീപ്പിംഗ് ഓൺ ഹിസ് ചെയർ.
വെയിറ്റ്. ബിഫോർ ഗെറ്റിംഗ് ഇൻ ദ പോം, വി ഹാവ് ടു ഡിസ്കസ് the homework that we had given to the students in the last episode. In the last episode, I asked you to write the summary of the four stanzas. And here, one of my students has sent me a voice message. Now, let us listen to Gayatri. Here is the answer.
Father Peter Gilligan is an old priest. He helps the people in his parish. Half of his people are in debt or buried under the ground. He treats the sick people and conducts funeral for the dead. He treats them day and night and becomes very tired. He is now about to sleep in his chair. At that time, a poor man sent for him. The priest gets upset. He complains that he does not have rest, joy, or peace because people die and die. Then he feels sorry for saying such words. He begs God to forgive him because those words are spoken by his weak body, but not by him. Then he kneels down and prays God to forgive. Then he leans on the chair and sleeps.
Nice. Thank you, Gayatri. And now, let us read the next two stanzas. Please don't forget to list the unfamiliar words, okay?
They slowly into millions grew, and leaves shook in the wind, and God covered the world with shade and whispered to mankind. Upon the time of sparrow chip, when the moss came once more, the old priest Peter Gilligan stood upright on the floor.
Hope you have read the lines. What could you understand from these lines? What are the words and expressions that came to your mind? Please write them down. Which time of the day is mentioned in the expression the moss came once more? Yes, it's again in the morning. Some other expressions also are there about the morning. Which are they? Find them out. They slowly grew into millions. Have a look at the line. Okay, they slowly grew into millions. Who are they? Yes, stars. Stars grew into millions. Now, please have a look at this animation video. Hi friends, Hope you have enjoyed the video. What was the feeling? Yes, it's a nice description of the night. And stars are appearing in the sky and they are growing into millions. And it is getting darker and darker. Hi friends, now let us discuss the difficult words. How many difficult words are there? And let's come to the first one. Million. What does the word mean? Million. Thousand, thousand. Okay. Or 10 lakh. It's a number. Okay. Million. Yes. There's a lion in the palm and whispered to mankind. What does the word whisper mean? Whisper. Whisper. To speak softly into one's ears. Mandrikiga. Sogaryam parayiga. Whisper. Okay. And now watch this video. What did you hear? Yeah? Tell me. What was the bird? What's the name of the bird? Is it a crow? No. Parrot? No. Then? Sparrow. Okay, nice. Sparrow. And its sound. Its sound. And it's called a sparrow chip. Sound of a sparrow. Okay? Now, dear students, let me ask you some simple questions. Okay. And the first one. Did Father Peter Gilligan go to the poor man's house immediately? Huh? No. Okay. Then what did he do? He leaned on the chair. He prayed. And he fell asleep.
He knelt and leaning on the chair. He prayed and fell asleep.
Okay. He prayed, leaned on the chair and fell asleep. And I hope you have seen the picture. Now the second question. Why did he fall asleep? He was very weak. So he fell asleep. It was not at all intentional. ഏയ് ഉറങ്ങണമെന്ന് വിചാരിച്ചിരുന്നതല്ല, ഉറങ്ങിപ്പോയതാണ് പാവം. ആൻഡ് നൗ ദ തേർഡ് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ, ഹൂ ബിഗാൻ ടു പീപ്? യെസ്, സ്റ്റാർസ്. ഓക്കെ, വി ഹവ് സീൻ ദ സ്റ്റാർസ് ഇൻ ദ ആനിമേഷൻ വീഡിയോ. ഓക്കെ, ദെൻ ദ നമ്പർ ഓഫ് സ്റ്റാർസ് ഇൻക്രീസ്ഡ് ഇൻ ദ സ്കൈ. ഓക്കെ, ഹൗ മെനി സ്റ്റാർസ് വേർ ദേർ ഇൻ ദ സ്കൈ? മില്യൺസ്. ഓക്കെ, മില്യൺസ് മീൻസ് ഹിയർ ഇറ്റ് മീൻസ് കൗണ്ട്ലെസ്. Many stars. Okay. There were many stars in the sky. The leaves shook. Why? There was a wind. Okay. And the leaves shook. There was a wind. A wind was blowing. Okay. How does the poet say that it was night? Yes. God covered the world with shade. Okay. When is the time of sparrow chip? Morning, noon, or evening? Yes, it's morning. The sparrow chip. It refers to the time morning. Okay. And then, how does he say that Father Gilligan woke up? Yes, he stood upright. Now, dear children, what can we understand from these two stanzas? Father Peter Gilligan didn't go to the poor man's house. Okay. He could not go to the poor man's house because he was very weak. So he knelt down prayed and leaned on the chair and slept down. And it became night. And the night came and the stars appeared. And Father Gilligan slept there on the chair. And in the next morning, he woke up. He stood upright. That means he woke up. Yes, Father Gilligan got up or stood upright in the morning. And then what happened to him? What did he do then? Okay, come on. Let us read the next two stanzas of our poem.
Mavron, Mavron, the man has died while I slept in the chair. He roused his horse out of his sleep and rode with little care. He rode now as he never rode, by rocky lane and fen. The sick man's wife opened the door. Father, you come again.
Dear students, let me ask you two simple questions. Okay, the first one. What did Father Peter Gilligan do after getting up in the morning? He rose his horse and rode carelessly to the poor man's house. He went fast to the poor man's house. Okay. He reached the poor man's house immediately.
Father, you come again?
Is the poor man dead?
Yes. He died an hour ago. When you were gone, he turned and died peacefully.
The next question. What did the poor man's wife ask Father Peter Gilligan? What did she ask? Yes, she asked, Father, you come again. She was surprised. Okay. Father, you come again. Okay. Yes, I hope you have listed some difficult words. Okay. And there is Mavron. Mavron. What does it mean?
Mavron. Mavron. The man has died while I slept in the chair.
Alas, okay, showing his sadness is an expression. Okay, ayyo, kashtam, ennokke artham parayam. Okay, the next word, rouse. Okay, Father Peter Gilligan roused his horse. See the picture. Okay, he roused his horse. That means he made his horse wake up from sleep. Okay, dear students, how did Father Peter Gilligan ride his horse to the poor man's house? He rode his horse very fast. He rode his horse with little care. Okay. Why did he ride his horse with little care? Father felt sorry that he could not go to the poor man's house the previous night. Okay. So he rode fast. He wanted to reach the poor man's house as fast as he could. Dear students, don't you want to know what happened next? Okay? Now let us read the next two stanzas and find out.
And is the poor man dead? He cried. He died an hour ago. The old priest Peter Gilligan in grief swayed to and fro. When you were gone, he turned and died as merry as a bird. The old priest Peter Gilligan, he knelt to him at that word.
What did the woman tell the priest? The woman told the priest that her husband had died an hour before he reached there. Now come to the word suede. Father swayed in grief. Okay? Suede means moving forward and backward, to and fro, or sideways. Okay? It indicates a movement. Here we have the usage, as merry as a bird. What does it mean? The poor man died as merry as a bird. That is, he died peacefully. The poet uses as merry as a bird. What figure of speech is used here? Yes, simile. As merry as a bird, as brave as a lion, as white as a dove, as cunning as a fox. Such usages are there. You can collect more. These usages are all examples of simile. Now we can say simile with the phrase like also. We can compare two things using the word like to. Okay. He fought like a lion. She sings like an angel. Such sentences are there. Now have a look at these words and frame such sentences. Why was the woman surprised? She was surprised to see the father again. Father knelt down on that word. Why? He was grateful to God. Father Peter Gilligan swayed to and fro. Why did he sway to and fro? He could not do his priestly duties. Have a look at this question. The poor man's wife was surprised to see Father Peter Gilligan again. Guess your answer from Father Peter Gilligan's responses and write a paragraph. Father Peter Gilligan failed to do his priestly duties to the poor man. Analyze why. Do you think Father Peter Gilligan can be justified? Support your answer with evidences from the text. Now, please have a look at this.
Poet Yeats uses a number of images in the poem. Those images provide us sensory experiences. What does sensory mean? We have five senses: eyes to see, ears to hear, nose to smell, tongue to taste, and skin to touch. Sensory means related to our senses, which help us to hear, see, smell, taste, and touch. First of all, let us consider visual images. How can we explain a visual image? It's an image related to sight. When we read a particular line or phrase, a picture of it comes to our mind. For example, when we read, "They slowly into millions grew," we get a clear picture of a starry night. Now it will be easy for us to make out what auditory image is.
Yes, it is related to audio. So please give me an example. Yes, the chirping of the sparrow. Nice. Now please go to activity 5 and complete the table. Identify more examples.
Now, dear children, look at these pictures. They are arranged in sequential order. Identify the ideas connected with these pictures. Think about the ideas and write down the sentences. This is an assignment for you, and you please send your answers to your teacher. Okay. Now, dear children, what might be the climax of this story? Let us discuss it in the next episode. Now, I am going to wind up this session. I am T.M. Damendran, Government High Secondary School, Nedungom. Goodbye.